Redeemer family, especially children and parents of children. This is Rob Paynter. I'm a father, husband, pediatrician, son of the king. Not in that order, actually. Becky and I are listening to Michael Anderson's Daily Wash. And if you're not on that bandwagon, you need to figure out how to get on it. Actually, in this case, it's a band camp, and it involves lots of musicians that we know. A gift to hear a different song every day. Wendy asked me to speak to you regarding the current pandemic, mostly from a pediatrician's role. This is really an unprecedented time for us, but not for everyone. Some people who are alive today have lived through similar events and struggles. It has been a virus. It's been war. It's been slavery or injustice. But this time it is a virus, and no matter what causes it, that can bring about feelings of fear and a loss of control. Mostly because it brings up questions that we just can't answer well. But that's okay, because as Christians, we can be sure that our King does know the answer. In the case of you and your family, God made your hands with His hands. He made them strong and mighty. He made you creative with your hands, so you can use them for many works, hopefully good. He also made them easy to clean. And that's the number one way to keep yourself from getting sick. Cleaning your hands with sanitizer or soap and water is one surefire way to keep yourself well. And actually, that includes like not touching your nose or your mouth or your eyes. Thankfully, He did not make this virus to fly. He also made your immune system miraculous. So this virus, like many other viruses, who here hasn't heard of hand, foot, and mouth? Or even minor colds. Those are all viruses, and your body was made to fight them off and help you get better. For this virus, kids' immune systems fight really well. So between washing your hands, staying away from those who might be sick, and the miracle of your immune system, you should be just fine. It's wild to think about, but you know, there are many kids in China too, and in Italy, and those kids, just like you, are living under similar changes in how they go to school or don't go to school, how they play, how they see their friends. And even though it seems like it could be worse there, there have actually been very, very, very few kids with any serious illness from this virus. That's something to be thankful for, but it's not something to make us less vigilant. Do you know most of the kids in the studies looking in China and Italy, caught the virus from someone they knew had the virus? It didn't just pop up out of nowhere in children. For those new babies in our midst, and there are always new babies in the Redeemer midst, I would suggest that a phone call or a congratulatory text would be the best place to start. Food is always welcomed, and while the baby has a fantastic immune system that is already working behind the scenes, babies haven't seen any sickness yet, and they only have about 7 pounds of fighting weight. That's not very much. So staying away and making sure that they are only around family members is really important during the first 4 weeks. That really doesn't change anytime there's a new baby, pandemic or not. So just as we think about how our mayor made a really hard decision to kind of shut down the city, there is a light that we can see at keeping our distance. It will start to work. That doesn't mean being afraid to speak to others as we see them on the sidewalk, or walking to the mailbox, or at the store. It does mean, if you're sick, stay home and rest until you're better. Drink plenty of fluids, join the online prayer times, and keep your eyes on Jesus. Just like in Numbers 21, it wasn't Jesus the Israelites had to keep their eyes on. But there is a really similar story of God's faithfulness. It'll also give you some really good questions to wrestle with Giorgio, Tripp, and Chris. So keep your eyes fixed on the author of our peace, and He will help us look forward without fear. Thank you, Redeemer. And if you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out. Thanks.